Each fall, these University of Southern Mississippi researchers take to coastal watersheds, estuaries, and barrier islands to study Gulf sturgeon.
I think the unique thing is, one, no one's ever studied it in great detail in our system, which is something we need to know.
Gulf sturgeon spawns in fresh water and later moves as juveniles and subadults to the estuary, and as adults move to marine environments like the barrier islands every year. The research project examines where the fish go and how long they stay.
NOAA and other agencies have hired us to look at where the juveniles, subadults, and adults spend their time effectively. And we did most of this in the Pascagoula, but we're also working off Gulfport, and we're also working on our barrier islands.
Gulf sturgeon is federally protected as a threatened species due mainly to construction of dams and rivers and overfishing practices. Projects like this one help agencies decide when to dredge channels and to maintain harbors, based in part on the movement of Gulf sturgeon in these habitats. Scientists believe the condition of the Gulf sturgeon provides a much bigger picture of how the environment overall is doing.
We use this in terms of understanding river systems in general. If the sturgeon are doing very poorly for whatever reason, it would suggest that the river is having some issues as a whole ecosystem.
Dr. Peterson says advances in technology are giving researchers opportunities to better track the fish and preserve the sturgeon's spawning and feeding habitat from Florida to the Pearl River. From the University of Southern Mississippi, I'm Layla Essary.